Alcohol addiction can be broken down into seven criteria. The first criteria is tolerance, and tolerance simply means a person can drink more and more over time. The second criteria is withdrawal. So when a person stops drinking, they experience symptoms of irritability, of anxiety, shakes, sweats, nausea, or even vomiting. The third criteria is difficulty controlling their drinking. So a person drinks more and more over time, and they drink for longer than they would like as well. The fourth criteria is negative consequences. So a person continues to drink even though they experience negative consequences to their mood, their self-esteem, their health, and their worth. The fifth criteria is significant time and emotional energy spent. So a person spends a significant amount of time thinking about it, obtaining, drinking, concealing, and planning, and also recovering from their drinking. The sixth criteria is putting off and neglecting activities. So a person has given up or reduced their social, recreational, work, or household activities because of their drinking. And the last criteria is a desire to cut down. So a person has repeatedly thought about cutting down or controlling their drinking, or has made unsuccessful attempts to cut down or control their drinking. What's important to also note is what addiction is not. So you do not need to use every day. The main issue is to highlight here is if a person has difficulty controlling their use or has experienced negative consequences, then addiction may well be present. You do not need to crave alcohol. A person can go for a whole month or more without thinking about drinking or even craving alcohol. And you do not need to go through withdrawals. Every person is different when it comes to withdrawals. Some may experience significant withdrawals, whilst others very little. And there is no correlation between how much withdrawal is experienced and the extent of one's addiction. You do not need to suffer major losses or consequences. If family and friends have commented on a person's drinking, have an impact on their lives, then it may well be a sign that all is not well. It takes family members' courage to make even the smallest comment about a person's drinking. A little concern in their eyes can be a consequence in itself. So if you experience any of those criteria, especially if you experience 3 out of the 7 in any of the 12-month period, then I would encourage and suggest you contact a mental health professional.